easy, decimals, multiplication. By the time you get to this bit of mathematics, you already have some cool multiplication skills. You've learned your tables, and you've probably also learned more than one strategy to multiply numbers together. There's one more thing you need to ace multiplying decimals. You need to be able to count. Of course you can do that, so you're going to ace this topic in math. Before we get to that, let's pin down our terms. The number system we use is the base 10 system. It's called the decimal system. But when we talk about a decimal number, we mean a number with a decimal point and some figures after it. A decimal figure is a digit that comes after the decimal point. This number has two decimal figures. Okay, now let's get on to the new stuff. We're going to multiply two decimal numbers. Here they are. The trick is we multiply without thinking about the decimal points. And then after we've done the multiplication, we put the decimal point back in at the end. And that's where the counting part will come in. We start off thinking about these significant figures, the 2 and the 6. We multiply them together. Of course, that's 12. And now we put those decimal places back into the answer. In the original numbers, we've got two decimal figures here and one here. And we need three decimal figures in the answer. I only have two figures right now. Not a problem. I write a couple of zeros in front of my 12. Starting from the right, we count to the left. One, two, three figures, and here's the decimal point. 0.012. I have three figures here. We're all done. And that's it. Let's do another one. 0.47 times 11. Ready to go in standard algorithm form this time. I'll ignore the decimal point right now and just multiply like it's not even there. First row, 47 times 1, 47. Second row starts with a 0 because we're multiplying by 110. 1 times 7 is 7 and 1 times 4 is 4. Now add them up. First row, 7. Then 7 and 4 is 11. And here, 4 and 1 is 5. 517. Now we put in the decimal point. Here we have two decimal figures, so we need two decimal figures in the answer. Count from the right to the left. 1, 2, and there it is. 5.17, two decimal figures in the answer, all done. Pretty simple, right? Don't stop now, though, because there's a special case to watch out for, like in this example. Always focus on the multiplication first. 2 times 5 is 10. Notice it ends in a 0. Okay. Now we put in the decimal figures. Two figures here and one here. Three decimal figures to go in the answer. Put some zeros at the front. Now count. 1, 2, 3 figures. The decimal point goes here. 0.010. Hang on a moment. We know that we don't need that 0 at the end. It's just a placeholder. So there's one more step to show. Equals 0.01. Once you've done this step of putting the decimal point in the right place with the right number of decimal figures, then you can eliminate any zeros you got just hanging around at the end. And in fact, if we'd had this instead, we can eliminate those placeholding zeros before even doing the multiplication. So we're still thinking about 2 times 5, and we still have 3 decimal figures, and the answer is still 0.01. You can check this out on your calculator at your own pace. I think you'll have fun with it. It's strong stuff. Next time, I'll show you how to estimate your answer. This is cool because it lets you check your work and be able to give an estimated answer, because that's sometimes what a problem tells you to do. See you soon on Let's Do Math.